clears away. Johnson then swings the ball back and tries to get it into the area. Might befall Dan Hall here with a low drive, and he pulls one back. 3-2 now. Dan Hall with a really good finish. The defender driving low and hard to the right of Tomislav Romic.
Here is a deli. Nice, nice looking ball there for Ollie Scott. And it's that man again, Daniel Hall. That is some challenge there.
Kukubu driving that one forward. Was looking for Gonzalez, who dropped deep. But Hall had followed him. And Dan Hall now makes a foray forward into the area. Clips towards the back stick, looking for Mikey Katsoulis. Cuts it back and it's Damien Sakenis. In fact, no, it's not. Will be definitely missed. Hall nips in very smartly there and gets a bit of space coming forward. Here's Mikey Katsoulis. It's in the back of the net. Mikey Katsoulis draws first blood here at Plume Park. Aaron's just looking to settle into a bit of a rhythm here. Just dictate the tempo. Hall breaking crossfield ball. There is Cole Johnson for the Mariners. Dan Hall pressed by Wigan. Does well. Oh, lovely feed from Daniel Hall.
Trying to work it back in the middle. Hall able to work it.
It's been a big week for you. How do you feel about signing your first senior deal?
Pretty crazy how everything changed so quick, but I'm super stoked. Like, I mean, it's pretty much something I've been working towards for like most of my life, really. So for it to be official, like, it's just something awesome for like my family and I. So, you know, stoked.
How long have you been at the Mariners now?
I think about two years now, like just over 2 years. So I came, I think, about May 2018. So yeah, 2 and a bit years. Yeah, no.
So you were in the youth team and now you've stepped up to first team. Firstly, how long have you been training with the first team? And what's the intensity like in pre-season this year going into the season in December?
My first like time like in with the first team for like a more than like a week period would have been like post COVID. So when there was that COVID break, like where the A League shut down, on the restart, there was like a bubble. So I was included in that bubble. So like I was with them for about, I think, 4 to 5 weeks, like full time. And then MPL came back. So I went back with the youth team while they finished their A League season. And then obviously recently, since I've been like promoted, I've just been in with A-League full-time now. So, like, we're into pre-season now for next season. And, I mean, intensity question, like, yeah, you definitely notice there is obviously a big step up. I mean, like, the people, it's, like, their jobs to play football. So, obviously, they're going to take it proper serious. But I'm enjoying it, but it's definitely a challenge.
Today, I think I messaged you on Instagram about FBC sharing a news article about you. On their Facebook post about it, there was actually a few people asking what your ties to Fiji are, because it didn't mention in the article like how you're Fijian. So basically your background from Fiji, what sort of like town do you come from? Is it like Lataka, Suva, Nandi, somewhere else even?
Yeah, so birth mum's from Suva, but I was born in Melbourne, so that's where the tie comes in. So yeah.
Have you ever been to Fiji or?
Yeah, we've gone on a couple of holidays like to Fiji, and like I think it was 2018 April-ish. I went actually over for like an under 20 camp, so for like Fiji under 20s. So I was over there for about a week, and then that would have been the last time I've been back. So.
Oh, so you were in a camp for the Fijian under 20 team.
Yeah, correct. Yeah.
So you've actually been involved with like Fiji football beforehand.
Yeah. So like it was just like the one camp. I think it was like an under 20 camp. So I went over. That was still when I was just in MPL. So I went over, and then yeah, I was there for a week. I think we were at we were just at like the football center at bar, I think.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
I guess, how'd you find that week experience? Experience and something?
No, it was like, pardon?
Was it something completely new, like in terms of like being in camp for a week?
Yeah, so like that was obviously my first like ever like camp that I've done, whether it's here or over there. But yeah, definitely it was a great experience. Like took me a while to get used to the weather. It's just pretty so hot over there. But like no, I enjoyed it. It was good. Met a few of the guys. Like everyone was real nice. So and training was good. So I enjoyed it. Yeah.
I know like here in Melbourne, there's a big Fiji soccer community over in Queensland and in like Brisbane. Have you ever played in any Fijian tournaments in Queensland or even in New South Wales?
Yeah, no, I've played, I think about three in Brisbane. So I play for Ra. Yeah. So shout out to any of the Ra boys that are listening in. So top people. But no, I really enjoy playing for them. Top guys and good footballers too.
I guess growing up, how'd you get into soccer? Was it soccer always a major sport? You know, a lot of Fijian boys play rugby when they're younger. How'd you get into football?
So when I was born in Melbourne, we moved over to China pretty young. And in China, like with all like the other expats, like the only sport they were playing really was soccer or football. So kind of just, I was only six, so I just kind of jumped in and haven't really looked back really. So that was like my first sport. So I just kind of stuck with it and just been not going since.
Do you remember much from your time in China? Like what was that whole sort of cultural experience like? Because life's a bit different there. So
yeah, no, it's hectic. So like went over to at six. So I went to an international school, but I started school there. So I think it was kindergarten then. So I was there for like 3 years. So came back to Brisbane in grade three, year three. So yeah, no, it was, it was an experience. That's for sure. Like, I mean, lifestyle's completely different, but back then it was like really all I knew. So I enjoyed it, but I'm sure I've taken some good things away from it.
I guess moving from China to Brisbane, who were your junior clubs back in Brisbane? That you played for?
So first club I joined was Queensland Lions. So that was like the closest club, like 10 minutes up from our house. So we just kind of went there. Like we didn't really know what clubs were good, what weren't, but turns out they're a pretty solid club. Yeah, so it was there for, it was there for about like four years, something like that. And then ended up, I had a season in between where I went to Brisbane City. And then, like, I enjoyed it enough, but, like, I'd rather just – not enough to stay. So I ended up going back to Lions for a year. And then that's when I think the second year or third year of NPL. So I went back into NPL because Lions didn't have NPL at the time. And then that's where I went to Western Pride, so out in Ipswich, yeah.
What age group was that, Western Pride?
So that was first year was under 16s. So 16s. And then I was there for about three seasons before making the move.
Did you play senior football for them? Like in NPL?
Yeah. So 16s the first year and then 18s the next year. And then like on the end of that 18s year, I played a couple 20s games and then same thing. So then I was in the 20s and then made my debut in, I think, 2017. So I think I've had, I don't know, it wouldn't have too many games. Didn't start any, but I was just coming off the bench. But I had my debut in the NPL there.
How going from like debuting in the NPL to moving over to the Mariners, how did that sort of move come about?
That would have been, so 2018, it was pretty much right after I came back from that camp from Fiji. My coach got in contact with me and said that if I had a highlight video to like send through to like an A-League setup, but I wasn't sure what the club was at the time. Like he didn't tell me. And then eventually I found out like that I got the trial to go to the Mariners. And then, so that's how that all happened.
How long, like, was the trial for? Was it like a week thing, or was it just come trial as long as you can, see how you go until they say no or say yes type of thing? Or
yeah, so since it was like the youth team, it was like a it was only 3 days. So I flew down. They were like, it was like a whole heap of trialists, but some reason, like, even though I was meant to only trialing youth team, there was like the first 2 days I was with the A-League setup. So like, it was like the first 2 days with the A-League boys. So that was like my first ever experience with like training again, playing against A-League players, which was pretty surreal at the time. And then the last day I trained with the youth boys, and then I headed back home after.
And was it just they reached back out to you and said, yeah, we like you, we want to sign you type thing? Or
yeah, so it was like Ken Shembury, the academy director there. After the third day, he talked to me and said, like, if I was, he said his wording was that he was optimistic for me. I still remember. He said he was optimistic. And in my head, I'm thinking, does that mean I'm signing or I'm not signing? So it's pretty confusing, but I just, he's a man of few words. So I just, I think it was on the way back. So after that, we went to the train because I had to get the train back to Sydney to fly back to Brisbane. And then I got a call from, at the time I was working with an agent, and he told me that they were interested in signing me for the youth team. So it's pretty hectic.
So I get, moving from Brisbane to Central Coast, was it something that, was it a move that you and your whole family made, or was it just you by yourself?
Yeah, so it was just me. So I think it was about, I moved down, drove down with all my stuff, like in my car, 3 weeks after I got told that they wanted me. Cause like at that point they were in season, right? So like they wanted me there to play. So yeah, it had to be a quick turnaround. So family are still up in Brisbane, and yeah, so I made the move down by myself.
Was that the first time living away from home, like away from family?
Yeah, first time. So like, yeah, no, it was, besides them going on holiday sometimes and leaving me at home, that was really like straight out of home, straight into the deep end, really.
How'd you adjust to, like, you know, no parents around, I guess having to cook for yourself, you know?
Yeah, so, first two months when I first like came down, I was actually in like a homestay set up. So like the club helped organize that, so it wasn't just like me by myself. So I was with a guy called Pierre.
It's 19 hours.
Top guy. So stayed with him for the first 2 months, and then that helped definitely to help me get adjusted to like living out of home by myself and stuff. And then eventually after that, I ended up moving into these apartments with like a few other teammates. So there were about four of us in like these one apartment block, and then that was when I was really just on my own with my teammates. So it was a good experience.
This season I noticed you were captain of the NPL side, captain of the Y League side as well, I believe. How did that come about? Was that like a coaching decision that the coaches made, or were you elected captain by the players?
Yeah, so it was pretty random. Not random, but like, so our previous captain had like, after that NPL leading into NYL, he had like moved on to another club. So we didn't really have a captain, and I didn't really think much of it. I was just kind of doing my own thing. And then I think a couple of trial games came leading into that NYL, and Ken, like the academy director, gave me like the armband for one of the trial games against Sydney. And I didn't think much of it. I just thought, yeah, it's, I guess someone has to be a captain during the game. So like, whatever, I'll take it. And then I remember it was that first NYL game. So it was down in Canberra, actually. We're on the bus to the game, and Monty, like the youth coach, called me up the front of the bus and said that he wants me to be the captain for the youth team. So yeah, I took on that role and gave it a crack, really.
How, I guess, going from not thinking much of it to knowing that you're going to be captain for probably pretty much the whole season. Like, how did that make you feel? Did you feel like, all right, I've got to, you know, sort of become a leader now? Or were you, did you already think of yourself as a leader in the playing group? Or, like, did your, you know, anything change for you?
No, I didn't try to change too much, really. Like, I mean, you can only be yourself. So, like, I guess I was always just, like, trying to be, like, a friend to all the teammates. And, yeah, no, I didn't, like, didn't try to overthink anything. Like, I mean, at the end of the day, it's just 11 people on a pitch. So, don't, if I overthink it, then I'm sure, like, I'll probably end up letting myself down or something. So, I just try and just focus on what I can control, really.
So I guess going from captain of the youth team to signing your first senior contract, does anything like change for you personally there in terms of, you know, are you vocal out on the training pitch and telling players where they need to position themselves, or, you know, if someone's not pulling their weight in training, are you going to be the person that tells them to pull their head in, let's say?
Yeah. I'll be honest, I haven't really thought about my approach going into that, but, like, I guess at the end of the day, we're all teammates, so if I can encourage someone, I will, but then again, I know my place, so I'm not going to go boss around, like, a Matt Simon or a Bozanic telling them what to do when they've had, like, I don't know how many games in the A-League, a ridiculous amount, so, but... No, it's definitely something I will work towards in time.
Nice. Looking at last year's A-League season, the 2019-2020 season, you know, Alan Stagic blooded a lot of youngsters in the first team. You had guys like Joshua Nisbet, Aloe Kwol, who had that really funny post-game interview that I think that everyone talks about. Lewis Miller was, like, pretty much right back, you know, for a good stretch of games. I'm sure there would have been other players, Sam Silveira, who's in Portugal now, Dylan Ruiz Diaz. I guess being a youngster in the NPL team, you know, does that give you confidence to be like, I've got a first team coach that gives youth the chance, I'm in the right place?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, like, you can just look, like, if you look at that team there, like, how many youngsters there were that are getting regular game time in the A-League. So that's something huge for not just me, but any other young footballer at the Mariners that want to push on. But, I mean, yeah, no, 100%, like, seeing, like, players like Nizzy and all the other boys just, like, getting consistent game time, it's something that we can all aspire to, really.
I'm guessing most of those boys would have been your teammates previously, like you would have played NPL with them and Y-League with them.
Yeah, no, well, all of them, and, like, especially Nizzy, see, like, because he's from Queensland, so I've been playing with him since we were 10, so it's pretty crazy that we're here now somehow together, so it's pretty crazy, but, no, it's like, I think Louis, Diaz, all of them, really, we've played, like, at least an NPL or NYL together somewhere along the line. So to see them push on is awesome.
You said earlier that you were involved in the post-COVID, you were involved in the bubble. So it sort of meant that you might have got your chance at the end of last season. Were you, I guess, disappointed that you didn't get an appearance or anything like that, seeing as though, like, a lot of you, you know, ex-teammates, a lot of youngsters were getting appearances. Were you, you know, disappointed at all not to feature last year, or was it just something that put my head down and continue to work towards it?
Yeah, no, like, I mean, at the end of the day, it's the gaffer's choice who he plays, who he doesn't. So, but at that time, like, obviously I would have been ecstatic to get, like, a game under my belt, but, like, I knew if it wasn't going to be then, like, it's not the end of the world. I'm just going to have to focus on what I can control. And at that time, it was the NPL. So we went back into the NPL and just kept my head down, kept working.
Talking about the NPL, you were awarded, I think it was man of the match in the final game. That on top of you got the Central Coast Mariners Y-League Player of the Year. I guess having those two accolades, what does it mean? What does it mean for you personally and for your family?
Well, family is obviously stoked with it. I mean, I try not to get too carried away with awards and whatnot, because there's always like a bigger picture in my mind. So it's obviously, I guess it is rewarding to get acknowledged for stuff like that. But if you always want to keep pushing on, I mean, it's just like another stepping stone. You know what I mean?
I saw in the highlights of the NPL 2 final game, you gave away a penalty. I think it was like the 70th minute. And then they obviously scored and made it 1-1. So you must have had a pretty good rest of the game to get man of the match. But I just want to talk about giving away the penalty. How did you feel at the time, and how did you sort of bounce back from this to, you know, to, I guess, help your team with the trophy?
Oh, well, when the pen first happened, I honestly thought I was going early showers for a red card, to be honest with you. But I somehow stayed on the pitch with just a yellow, so that was a little win. But I think just trying to regain focus and like not let it get to your head, because I know a lot of times if like you let that get to your head, you're going to be gone for the rest of the game. So obviously for the benefit of the team, I tried to stay focused. And like I knew like with like the attacking options we had up front, like there's going to be goals there. So as long as I keep the back end, you know, half tidy, we'll score up top and we'll be sweet. So just trying to regain focus mainly and keep going.
I guess not many, for those that don't watch the New South Wales NPL and I guess haven't watched the Y League, how would you describe your playing style, and what can people in Fiji who might be eagerly watching you this year at Central Coast, what can they expect to see from you? What sort of player are you?
So I think the best way I can describe myself would be, so I'm a ball playing centre back, so I don't just kick the ball. I like to try and play out. I think I'm half decent under pressure, trying to dribble out from the back. Not too bad in the air either, and I'll tackle when I have to, really. So, yeah, that's probably.
Are you more left sided or right sided centre back? Like, what foot are you? Or does it really matter? Play comfortably on either side.
So I'm right-footed, but I prefer playing left centre-back if I had a preference between the two, just because I'm not too bad with my left foot, so I don't mind using it. So, and then when I'm on the left side, it helps me when I dribble out, so I can always – I have one move that in my locker that I do, so it's always better if it's on the left than the right.
I mean, talking before, I didn't even know this about you being in camp in the under-20s, but I don't want to put any pressure on you to like announce anything or, you know, like close any doors or anything like that. But yeah, international playing future, I know like with the Olympics being moved to next year and a lot of the guys that were involved in the Olive Roos qualification looking like they're coming back to the A-League, would you say that a goal of yours is, you know, possibly trying to break into the Olive Roos team for the Olympics, or is that just a you're not thinking about that yet type of thing?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, like a week ago, I wasn't on a contract, really, a professional contract. So it's for me, it's just one step at a time. Like, I mean, I see what each day takes me. So it's, I guess we can all have goals and stuff. But at the moment, I'm just focused on, you know, settling into an A-League team and trying to do my best for the club.
And I guess if, you know, someone at the Fiji Football Federation sees this and they might think, oh, shit, we've got a guy playing professionally in the A-League, we need a cap in type of thing. If they were to invite you for a camp for the senior national team and said you maybe playing a friendly, that way you don't lock yourself in, would it be something you consider, or is it full focus at the moment just A-League?
Look, you'll have to get back to me on that one. I mean, I think obviously I wouldn't want to shut any doors, so there's always potential. But yeah, as I said, at the moment, it's just strictly just trying to settle into the new environment I'm in, but like, who knows what the future holds really. I mean, who knows really? Yeah.
Yeah. I guess let's talk about your life outside of football. How have you kept busy, at the Central Coast? What are your hobbies outside of football? Are you studying or working? Oh, well, we're not going to be working elsewhere anymore, but playing NYL where you work and elsewhere.
So with like the hours of like a youth team footballer, it's pretty hard to just get like a normal job. And like, because you're up in the morning and like you can have random gym sessions or other things on during the day. So it's pretty hard to just get like a normal retail job. So, I mean, I coach quite often. So for the club, I'm in like the juniors, I coach, and then I do like school clinics. So we go out in the van and like run programs for the kids. So that's what I've been doing when I'm not on the pitch, really.
What else? Like, what are your hobbies outside of football?
I mean, I live with a few of my teammates, so when we're not training, usually there's something to do around with them. Like, I know we go to the beach quite often, play basketball, just like anything, like just what normal people do, really.
Fair enough. Last question, I guess, advice for any young players out there. You know, there might be a young Fijian boy watching this now that is going to tell his parents that he wants a Dan Hall Central Coast Mariners jersey. But, you know, just advice for any junior NPL players, you know, wanting to become a professional player in Australia.
I think biggest thing would just be just stick with it, you know. Like, I didn't really have the highest – I didn't set the bar too far. Like, I didn't say, yep, I'm going to be an A-League player, I'm going to be a professional player. It was just one day at a time. Like, I always wanted to just be better than I was the season before. And, like, I think just sticking with it, because there's a lot of times where people just lose interest in the game or they turn away from the sport. So, for me, I just kept sticking with it. And, I mean, it's working so far, so hopefully it keeps going.